Hello there, you fantastic people. Panda here, and welcome to, well, it's going to be a little bit of a vlog. I'm just going to be talking a little bit about what's going on. And, you know, just a little update. You know how it goes. I do these every now and then. I've not done one of these in absolutely ages. We moved house at the end of February. And my God, we've just been getting a lot of stuff done. There's just been stuff to do left, right, and center. Me and my wonderful girlfriend, the mistress of the Badgers. We've been doing all sorts of stuff with the house. There will be a house tour video coming at some point. I promised you guys they would come, and I'm definitely going to do it. But first of all, the house needs to just get into a state where it looks nice. You know, if I showed you it now, you'd be like, wow, that looks kind of garbage. And that's understandable. You know, we'd not been in here that long. And also, Arcade came out a month ago, which we've been seriously no-lifing. So having time to do all of this stuff, it's not been there. But I am just making this vlog because I wanted to talk a little bit about what's going to be happening over the next week. I am going over to the Caribbean, which is where my dad lives with his girlfriend and their kids. With his girlfriend and her kids. And one of them is getting married. So we are going over to the Caribbean to go to the wedding. And also it means I'm going to be able to see my dad, which is absolutely glorious because I don't get to see him too often at all. So I'm really super looking forward to that. And we're going to be away for a week. So we're going to be away from the 9th. We're leaving on Wednesday and we're going to be getting back on the 16th, I think. And then once I'm back, I will try and get back into a decent schedule. I've just been trying so hard to get things done and at the same time, like play Arcage and render videos and upload videos and stream and all that stuff. And I'm going to be honest, it has got a little bit on top of me. Like I'm feeling the weight, I'm feeling the pressure right now. And the pressure is trying to crush me. But you know what? Hopefully once I get back, we can chill out a little bit. My dad's also going to be coming and staying with us for a bit afterwards, which is goddamn amazing. And I'll probably make a video with him or maybe even do a stream with him. We will have to see how all that goes, but I'm really looking forward to it. The last time we went out there was 2 years ago, I think. Yeah, I think it was 2 years ago, and we went out there for 2 weeks, and it was just a lovely time. And this time it's not for so long, but we do have a nice little break. And you know what? You know what? It's pretty welcome. It's definitely pretty welcome. This last year has been absolutely fantastic for the YouTube channel, insanely good for the Twitch channel, and really, I've been trying my hardest just to keep on top of everything and keep it going, and it's gone great. In the last year, we've essentially got 100,000 subscribers, which is huge for me, because before that, for years, I was just losing subs every day, and then somehow we've gotten to the point now where I'm gaining subs every single day, pretty much, which is... it's goddamn amazing. It's really nice. And we're slowly pushing towards that 500,000 sub mark. What are we at right now? Let's have a little look. Okay, so we're at 494,300. That's pretty good. That's only 6,000 away. We were above 450,000, but then YouTube did one of its scheduled clear outs and every single channel on YouTube lost a bunch of subs. I lost 1,500 subs. That's okay though. I can deal with that. We will hopefully make it up soon. And we have coming up, we've got some good things coming up on the channel. I just want to talk a little bit about Kingdom Come and Alien Isolation and the double uploads that I was doing for a decent while and then kind of have halted recently. I do really, in an ideal world, want to be able to get 2 videos out a day. I want to put one out around my lunchtime and then one out around like 6, 7 p.m. my time. That works for me. And the way that I want to do that is that I say that early upload is something like Kingdom Come that not everyone's enjoying, you know, not a ton of people watching it, but it's something that I'm really enjoying myself, and that's something that I've always tried to prioritize with my YouTube channel, make sure that I'm enjoying myself, because there's probably stuff that I could do that would get views that I wouldn't really enjoy. Like I could probably make some Fortnite content, I could probably make a couple of decent Fortnite videos and get like a bunch of views, but I'm not really big into Fortnite, you know? If I was really super into Fortnite and I was making Fortnite videos, fair enough, you know, that would be great, but I'm not going to force myself to do it. Anyway, so we have the early uploads that I want to be like Let's Play content, so say Kingdom Come or Alien Isolation, or we did Resident Evil 7 before that. All great games, all super fun, definitely enjoying all of them, but those want to be the first one. And then something in the evening, in the afternoon upload, I want to have something that, you know, more people want to watch, like Dead by Daylight or We Happy Few back when I was doing that. Really looking forward to We Happy Few being released, by the way, during summer. That's going to be sweet. But basically videos that get, you know, a bit more interest. And that's kind of how I want to do. And that's the ideal for me. But I've been experiencing a lot of issues with my computer. But honestly, this computer, since I first built it, has been a complete fucking nightmare. It's just got issues. And you know what? I'm always having computers problems. Like, that's just me. In a nutshell, if I had to write a bio about me, it'd be like, 31 years old, from England, breaks computers, or computers break on him. Because I've not done anything particularly bad to this computer. but it just hates me. Anyway, so I am in the process of buying a new PC and getting this company Utopia Computers to build it for me up in Scotland. They're going to send it down, and that should be awesome. And also, having two PCs means that I can actually get this one sorted out and I actually try and get this one repaired and find out what's wrong with it. Because right now, there's definitely problems with it, but I can't go and give it to a specialist or have someone come and take a look at it because it's out of my house. For even a day, that means that there's no uploads, that means that there's no stream, and I'm just sort of stuck in this horrible position. Like right now, I cannot do anything while I'm making a video. While I'm rendering a video, I can't watch a Twitch stream, I can't play any games. I've literally just got to walk away from my computer for like 2 hours sometimes and just let it do that thing. So usually I render stuff overnight, but at the moment I'm really enjoying Arcage. Like I'm playing it all the time, I've got a bunch of friends playing it, and we're trying to sit there and play the game, and you know, I've got to sit there and render and I can't do anything. So when there's another computer here, I can have one computer for fucking around on, and then I have one computer that's just constantly rendering videos, constantly just working, getting content made. And I really think that I will be able to get back to the two upload a day thing and do it quite comfortably with two computers here, especially if this one gets sent off and gets fixed. So I'm really excited about that. That's going to be goddamned awesome. And often I think, you know, I'm sitting there and I'm like, man, I'd love to just make a vlog right now. But then I'm like, ah, shit, I've got to render this and I've got to render this and I can't do this. Hopefully with the second computer, we'll have it set up here and it will be absolutely awesome. And hopefully the content will start flowing a little bit more easily, you know, because at the moment it just crashes. Sony Vegas just crashes. And I know I should use Adobe Premiere. I know. But I've been using Vegas for so long now. I've been using it for about 7 years. The idea of switching over to a different editing software just scares the crap out of me. It's like, I'm gonna have to learn everything again. At some point, I'm gonna sit down and do that. But it really is a daunting task. And it's not something that I'm looking forward to whatsoever. I'm pretty happy with Sony Vegas. When it doesn't crash, it's great. I know how to use it. I can edit a video in like record speed because I'm just super speedy now with all the keybinds and stuff. But I will switch over to Adobe at some point and we'll see how that goes. But I really do want to thank you guys that are watching the Kingdom Come and the Alien videos. I'm really enjoying that content. My dad's enjoying watching the Kingdom Come, which honestly means a huge, huge, huge amount to me. And that's enough to keep me going doing the videos anyway. Even if there was only 200 people watching the videos, if my dad was one of those people, I would totally be all about that because I absolutely love my dad to bits and I don't see him anywhere near often enough. Everyone always likes to ask how the animals are doing. Monkey is doing fantastically. He's such an amazing little dog. Love him to bits. And Marmite the cat is also doing absolutely super. They're both settling into the new house pretty well. The cat's still a little bit skittish, you know, he doesn't really know what to think. He's been uprooted from where we were living for ages and he's been put in here, but you know what? Their place here is so much nicer. We've got a much bigger garden. It's not next to a busy road or anything. So, you know, I'm happy. I'm happy that he's gonna be happy in the future once he gets completely used to it and, you know, he owns the roost. Marmite is just an absolute warrior cat. I'm absolutely certain of that. You know, after he got hit by that car and his eye was all destroyed and stuff, I'm sure that he is just the king of the castle when it comes to the gardens. You know, I'm sure he's that one-eyed badass cat that doesn't give a fuck and just attacks everyone. Other cats, at least. So he's just getting to the top of the hierarchy at the moment, I'm sure, and soon he'll just be settled into it. And Monkey's absolutely loving it. We've got a dog next door that's constantly barking at him, and they just chase each other up and down the fence. It's super cute. As far as games that are coming up that I'm looking forward to, we're still waiting for Last Year, which they've rebranded to Last Year, The Nightmare. Still waiting for that to come out. It's going to be a Dead by Daylight style game, and it looks to be pretty goddamn fun. I really hope that it works out like they seem to be saying that it's going to work out and that everyone wants it to work out. Like, everyone's pretty much waiting on that at the moment. It should be quite exciting. And apart from that, State of Decay 2 is coming out on the 22nd, which I think I'm going to be doing on the YouTube channel. Also, at the end of the month, we've got Agony, that game that I put up a video of a while ago of the demo, that's basically you in hell with loads of just tits everywhere. Interesting game. Should be fun. We will see. Also got a ton of big jump scares coming in Alien Isolation. I am loving this game. Just everything about it is just perfect. It is actually goddamn terrifying though. I was recording yesterday and I got so scared that I made a sound that I don't think I've heard myself make before. It was a good scare. Anyway, that piece is coming up, and really I'm just trying to work to get as much stuff as I can done and rendered and scheduled to upload for that week that I'm away so that I don't miss upload days even while I'm out of the country. And then I can really just sit and just relax over in the Caribbean, just put my feet up, have a nice lunchtime cocktail, and just pass the fuck out. That just sounds great to me. That sounds like the rest that I really, really, really am after. And yeah, it's gonna be fucking sweet. Just wanted to really say thank you so much, everyone, just for watching over the past year. It's been pretty freaking crazy, and I'm really hoping that I can continue to make content that you guys are enjoying. That is my dream. You know, that is the thing, and we're pretty much living the dream at the moment. The stream has been going so well. Like, I always saw people with 1,000 viewers in their stream, and I was like, God damn it, that's fucking incredible. And you know what? We actually managed to hit 1,000 viewers now. A few months ago, we were hitting like 1,400, even hit 2,200 one day. But it's coming down a bit. I think DBD at the moment is just in not the greatest spot. Like, people aren't particularly loving the newest killers. You know, the newest killers have been a bit of a letdown. Freddy, the pig, not so great. Leatherface, pretty goddamn boring. I'm looking forward to the new killer, which should be coming out in June or July, they said, for the 2-year anniversary. It seems to be teased to be some sort of ringleader thing. We will see what it is. I'm really quite excited about that. Whenever they make a new killer, it absolutely makes my day. But they're making us wait so long this time. They had said previously that they want the new killers to come out every 3 months in 2018, and yet we had the pig in January, and we're gonna have to wait till June to get it. Little bit saddening, but that means they're gonna have to pump out the rest of the killers pretty goddamn swiftly. And I'm just looking forward to seeing what it is. I can't wait to see a new original killer from the DBD folk, because they've made some great things. They've come up with some great, great, great ideas in the past. The Doctor is a cool as hell killer. The Huntress is awesome. I love the Wraith, Hillbilly, you know, Nurse. All of these things are great. And then I feel like they've really, apart from Michael Myers, kind of shit the bed a bit with the licensed killers. Like, they're not great. They're just not fun. They're just not the greatest. So yeah, I'm hoping that the new killer is going to absolutely just breathe some life into the game and be super, super exciting. So thank you very much for watching. I just wanted to have a little bit of a chat here. Thank you so much for the support, and I hope that I can continue to make content that you're going to enjoy going through to the rest of 2018. I promise that at some point it's going to get a little bit more regulated and do some more sort of fun vlogs, and I try and just do some fun stuff. I've got some cooking videos planned. You know, I just want to make it a good time. And honestly, I think the second computer is really going to change that in a big way. If it doesn't, then fuck, I screwed up. But I really think it will. And yeah, it's been a lovely year. Have a great week. I'm going to be off to the Caribbean. Going to go sunbathe and have a nice time and swim in the sea. I will catch you guys when I'm back. I might have some people do some guest streams over on Twitch on my stream while I'm away. We're going to have to see about that. I've got a few people in mind, but I've not really asked them yet. But that is the plan. And I will see you then. Have a great week. Goodbye, guys. Panda out.